Isaiah?
Hey, Arthur.
Come on! If we're gonna make it to this party, we sure as shit better clean up a little.
So we're doing this?
Oh, yeah. Old friend Dutch van der Linde is finally showing his true colors. Social climbing.
Old Signor Bronte, that horrendous snake, has invited us to the ball, Cinderella. So my suggestion is we go and get you a gown.
You son of a bitch.
We are ridiculous.
Utterly.
I ain't never been to a ball in my life.
Nor have I, if I am being honest.
I used to quite often. There could be fine pickings.
Oh, no pickpocketing. We are here to make real contact.
What kind of contact?
Well, I don't know. We'll find what we can. All I know for sure is we are going to a party at the mayor's house, and the guest of honor is the worst crook in town. I am sure that we will find something.
Okay.
Gentlemen, Luca, I'm afraid the mayor does not allow guns at official functions after last year's incident. Luca here will take you to Mr. Bronte. I believe he is expecting you.
Follow me, gentlemen. This way, please, gentlemen. Signor Bronte will be so pleased that you made it.
We are honored to be here.
That's wonderful, wonderful. Come, this way. What a beautiful evening it shall be. Mr. Bronte is a very good friend with the mayor. Good evening, Pierre.
Signor Napoli?
As long as the mayor behaves himself, you know. Mr. Bronte, he has that thing, you know, respect.
Jose, Bill, you join the party. We'll meet you out back after we pay our respects to Signor Bronte.
Come.
We'll meet you out in the balcony when you're done.
Cowboys, you've arrived, and you've washed per la prima volta questo mese senza dubbio.
This is quite a party you've invited us to.
Yes, quite something, although I'm not quite sure what.
So, this is Saint Denis High Society.
Yes, apparently so.
And all these people, these are friends of yours, Signor Bronte?
No, not quite. But they certainly are afraid of me, like that one. See, that wretch is the mayor. Henri Lemieux. He'll do anything for a dollar, and I mean anything.
Politics is a foul business. Yes.
Oh, and that one, too. That is Alberto Fusard. He owns a sugar plantation out on the island, and he comes here to whore and despoil himself. Oh, and that is Hobart Crawley, a Confederate major in the war. I mean, hero, they say, but that is his very young wife. I mean, a young mistress, that's the natural order of things, yes, but a young wife is unseemly. Oh, the Redskins. I have no sympathy for them, because whoever is stupid enough to get tricked by the Americans, no, they get what they deserve, huh? Yes, and a letter to the mayor. Oh, yeah, that'll save you. And that is Hector Fellows. This self-righteous newspaper man. Maybe you will kill him for me one day.
Well, we're not paid killers as such. Not in cold blood, anyway.
I did not know you were so particular that you wouldn't help a friend.
Oh, I'm willing to help in any way I can, within reason.
I'm going to pretend to understand what that means.
I meant no offense, sir.
None taken. All these vulgar people. They hate me. Non vedo l'ora di guardarti morire.
Well, it has been wonderful conversing with you, but I can tell that you are very busy, and I won't waste any more of your time.
Yes, yes, yes. Go, enjoy yourselves, and mingle with this vulgar scum. It'll make you long for the days when you could shoot each other and screw cows out on the open range.
Those sure were the days. Good day, gentlemen.
Good day to you. But before you go, what exactly are your plans here?
Well, we've not made any... Well, we are going to need some money.
Money, yes, of course. Well, there's money at the trolley station. They keep a lot of cash there in the day. Now, I could not involve myself in such matters. But you... As a guest? Yes. As my guest? Bah! Do it, huh? Okay, good day, gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Okay, ragazzi, adesso il vino buono.
Sì. I'll show you to the party, gentlemen, if you'll kindly follow me. Gentlemen, enjoy your evening and welcome once again to Saint-Denis. Ciao, ciao.
Gentlemen, let's go ingratiate ourselves. Okay. Go find the mayor if you can and stay out of trouble and steal nothing unless it's information.
Of course.
Jose, you go find us someplace to rob. Bill, go make us some new friends. I'm gonna find out if old Cornwall and what's his name, Milton, knows we're here. Gentlemen, be well.
Good night, sir.
Hello, mister.
Oh, you're not such a Philistine as all that, Marie.
No, I am quite that much of a Philistine. Besides with...
Would you like some champagne?
Of course. Thank you, sir. You are quite the gentleman. Clearly not from this swampy hellhole.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies, I'll see you next week.
You went.
Outrageous. These lambs are good.
Sir? Sure.
Gentlemen, I hope you're having a fine evening.
Ah, Mr. Mayor, wonderful to see you again.
Lemieux, this intellectual here was just insulting me regarding the Redskin.
I did no such thing. But, Mr. Lemieux, I suggested that all of us, as Americans, had a duty to take care of people living in this land. And that extends to Saint-Denis.
But, Mr. Miller, the Indian problem is not an urban problem, but a rural problem.
It ain't complex, Lemieux. And only an idiot like you, buddy, would try to make it so.
I will not deny idiocy, sir, but perhaps now is not the time.
Typical pansy!
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk. Yeah, what say you and me cool off?
Get your hands off me.
Come on, sleep it off. Sit down and calm down.
Count to 1,000.
Then you can rejoin the party.
Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Henri Lemieux. I hope you're enjoying my party.
The mayor.
Allegedly.
There's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. Do you know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. A writer?
We seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
My lord, they're fantastic.
Excuse me, pardon. Monsieur, please. Mr. Cornwall was quite insistent, I'm afraid. He shouted down the telephone for several minutes.
Mr. Cornwall is a horse's ass, and a bad horse.
I'm very sorry, sir.
It's not your fault. I'm a fool for trusting him. I'll come in and sign it in a minute. Let me enjoy the fireworks.
Of course.
Let me say something about Cornwall. Yes, find out what.
Everything's fine. We have the place well secured.
Good.
Mr. Bronte has a habit of wandering about and reading whatever he likes.
We're watching him and his men like hawks.
Thank you, Mr. Turner. Who do you think you are? This area is not meant for the likes of you. You know this. The standards in this house are slipping. This is a final warning to you, miss. A final warning. Now get out of my sight.
Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Top secret. Extremely confidential. Very interesting.
Thank you.
think so.
Nothing. This town is a waste of time.
Maybe not.
Arthur? Gentlemen, I think we're done here.
What did you find out?
There's plenty of money moves through here, of course, and I think I found out how we can grab some of it. Big bank. Real one, I mean. But not yet.
A city bank?
Maybe. And a stuffed one. If we're gonna leave, that could be the one thing we need.
There's also that trolley car station Senor Bronte told us about, and I heard about a high-stakes poker game. Come on.
Here comes Lenny. All right. Let's get in. Go home!
I ain't never felt so awkward in all my life. All them folk all so pleased with themselves. Oh, high society's pigeon shit. If you ask me, it's more like torture.
Well, that's sort of the point, isn't it? Let the people torture themselves.
Here's them papers I took.
Anybody see you take this?
I don't think so.
I might have an idea. Let me think on it. Interesting times.
I guess. So what's next? Dancing lessons? Deportment?
More along the lines of armed robbery. Jose is handling reconnaissance on the bank. He and Abigail are gonna run some distractions, see how the law react.
Good.
Oh, and I spoke to Evelyn Miller. Fine man. Here helping the Indian chief we saw.
Yeah, I met him too, with the mayor.
He's lobbying officials in Saint-Denis on their behalf. Maybe we could help.
Maybe.
Now, I think there's a lot of money on the riverboat. A lot of money. And Trelawney, he's investigating for us. He says to meet him at the tailor's.
Okay.
One big score down here, Arthur, and we disappear. We are almost heading home.
Where is home?
I don't know. Exactly. But I can smell it. I'm gonna go investigate this trolley thing old Bronte was talking about.
Okay.
My dear Arthur, I hope this letter finds you well. I wanted to thank you for your help with Jamie. He and Daddy are still arguing, but I understand that Jamie is thinking about going back to college. Whatever happens, I believe you saved his life and we are all truly grateful. Oh, Arthur, I have made such a mess of my life, time and again. Why can I not change and be the woman I want to be? Why couldn't you change and be a man and put down all those fantasies that shroud your judgment? Life is very confusing. And I see now that I am not very good at it. I'm afraid we've got ourselves into another mess. It's not my fault, but I need your help. I'm staying at the Hotel Grand in Saint-Denis. Oh, Arthur, I know it is wrong to ask you, but I have nobody else. And for what we once had together, I beg of you, even though I am ashamed to do so. Yours, Mary.
I should have broken your neck long ago.
Well, ain't that charming?
You revolting old bastard.
Can't you hassle someone else for a change?
How you keeping? Never better.
That's a lie, but not so bad.
You gonna make it out of this mess?
Sure. Maybe.
Good morning.
I don't know. Life is the mess, but I reckon we can give the law the slip one more time.
And then what?
We'll disappear. Like a memory, we'll just fade away. Grow old and bored.
And people just gonna forget about us? That's nonsense. People don't forget.
Rest
Nothing
up, Arthur.
Gets forgiven.
I disagree. When you're my age, you realize more gets forgotten than remembered. And forgiveness, well, mostly that's God's business, but for the rest of us, just an easy way of saying I don't care no more.
That's so.
Yes.
Hello, Mary Beth.
Oh, how are you, Arthur?
Fine. How are you?
Well, I'm well, I think. It's been quite a run we've had, but we're still alive.
So, no regrets?
Regrets for what?
Well, for joining this band of maniacs.
If you're a girl without means in this world, life is very scary. You boys care for me before no one cared for me. Well, life weren't very nice, Arthur. Not after Mama got typhoid, and that was a long time ago.
Sure.
What about you? I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Yep.
And?
Got me thinking how that all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. Or I wouldn't change.
Huh. Well, she was a fool then, Arthur.
Well, she put a lot of good years in on an outlaw. She definitely was a fool.
In these books, life seems so simple, but in reality, I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan! Mr. Morgan, we have a problem. A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
She's been taken by them Foreman brothers she used to run with. Come along!
The Foreman brothers? What are they doing here?
Well, I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
Sure. Do we need more guns?
You and I can handle this, Arthur.
Where are we heading?
I'll tell you on the way. Just get going. All right, head for Rhodes. And quick.
She's in Rhodes?
No. She's at a place called Radley's House, just west of there.
How do you know?
When we first got here, she told me she was worried that our camp was near a safe house that gang she ran with used from time to time.
And you told Dutch?
No. She spoke to me in confidence. I suppose I didn't think it would be a problem.
Now it is.
Oh, yes.
What do they want with her anyway? I think I saw one of the foremans hassling her in Valentine.
Yes. They probably followed us down here. You don't know what happened? She killed one of them for good reason, but clearly they don't see it that way.
Tilly?
Yes. Young Tilly Jackson isn't as sweet and innocent as you might think. But like I say, she was defending herself. She fled and fell in with us right after that. I just hope we can get to her in time.
It's not too far.
If they've touched a single hair on that girl's head, I will eviscerate the sons of bitches. Okay, I think that's the place up ahead.
I think there's a guard.
I'll deal with him.
Whoa.
What you want?
Kind sir, we're lost and in need of some help.
Oh, get out of here!
Oh, I see that kindly face of yours, and I know that for the right inducement, a gentleman such as yourself could be mighty kind.
Now get out of here.
Oh, now you keep saying that. But you don't mean nothing by it.
I said...
You said your last word! Well, what are you waiting for? Get in there and find our girl!
Shit!
It's okay, Miss Tilly. Now, let's get you out of here.
I thought there was...
Yeah, it don't matter what you thought. It's okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. There were five of them, I think.
Well, we killed those fellas there.
There they are.
Come on.
Tilly, grab that gun. Anyone approaches, shoot them.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be just fine. Now catch that bastard.
Get after them! There! Straight ahead! I saw him go through those bushes! You've got a couple more seconds to regret what you did! They're headed down the hill, to the water! You've got it! Oh, there they are, by the shoreline! That's it! I think that last one's the boss. Lasso him and we'll take him back to Tilly. Come on! Rope that bastard! Don't kill him yet. I want Tilly to have the last word on this bastard.
Yep.
Come on! Get him, Arthur! Don't let him get away! Make sure you tie him up real good.
I'll kill you!
Make these nice and tight.
All right. You bring that bastard back to Tilly so we can all have a nice little chat. I'm gonna head over there now to check she's okay.
With pleasure. Let's go for a ride.
Do you have the first idea what you're getting into? I'm Anthony Foreman.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Anthony. Is that Foreman with an A? I want the Undertaker to spell it right.
Funny bastard. Who are you running with?
She didn't tell you?
She didn't tell me nothing. This rope is cutting into me.
Don't feel so good when you're the one tied up, does it?
She killed my goddamn cousin.
Oh, don't worry. You'll be seeing him soon enough.
What are you gonna do with me?
I ain't sure yet. Reckon I'll let Tilly decide what you deserve.
You're wasting your time with that girl. She's a liar. She'll screw you over like she did me. I should have shot the bitch yesterday like I said I would.
You just shut your mouth now, Anthony. I've heard enough.
Son of a... yes.
All right. Here's your man.
Bring him here. Dump him on the ground here. I want to get a good look at this monster.
All right. Let's go.
So he's still alive then?
Yes.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman.
I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast. She's mine. She ate yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says, revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want.
Kill him, Arthur!
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave me alone!
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony? Or should I slit your throat and just save us all the bother?
I'll leave you alone. History is done.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat.
Go on.
Sadly, I agree with you. Sorry, partner. We can't take no chances with the likes of you.
Yeah.
Let's go, girl.
Yeah, I came. So, what do you need?
Wait there. I'm coming straight down. Arthur.
Hello, Mary.
You came.
Sure. Whenever you call for me, I'll come.
Oh, Arthur.
What's wrong?
Daddy.
Your father? I'm a bigger fool than I even thought.
I'm begging you, Arthur. I know Daddy was not kind to you, but surely you cannot hate a man for the sin of loving his daughter and wanting better for her than
me?
Then the choices you make...
What choice did I have? Did I ever have?
Oh, I know. You had to live by your code. But your code is... Well, it's not right.
Has your way been right, Mary? With you and Jamie joining a bunch of crazies? And hypocritical daddy with his drinking and whoring and gambling? Huh? Is that what a pure life has gotten you? Begging me for help?
Oh, Arthur. Be kind to me. Please.
Sorry.
I am... I should have asked someone else, but...
But I'm the best guy you know at frightening decent people.
It wasn't that I didn't love you, Arthur. You know that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Arthur. We were so very young. Think how different life could have been.
Yeah, I think about it. A lot. It all seems so long ago and far away now.
Will you help me try to save Daddy?
Come along, Dan. Where are we going? What's the old lovable patriarch been up to now?
Oh, Arthur, you know sarcasm is beneath you. He's been gambling and drinking and other things.
Oh, the filthy rotter. Where can we find him?
He said he was going down to the Theodore Eckhart stables. Something about a horse. It's down by the water in the warehouse district near the train yard.
Come on, then.
Don't be a pompous ass, Arthur. It doesn't suit you.
Oh, should I leave that to Daddy?
Leave Daddy alone. He suffers enough.
Well, I suppose I can take some consolation in that.
Oh, Arthur. I should have ran away with you years ago.
Well, you wouldn't.
No, I didn't. But, well, I don't know.
So what do you think he's up to?
I'm not sure. He keeps saying it's a disgrace a man of his standing has to ride around on some old nag.
Standing? He's usually falling down.
Arthur. He wasn't always this way, but it has got worse. He's drinking and gambling more than ever, pawning things off left and right, mixing with bad people. I'm just scared for him.
Don't worry too much. Whatever it is, we'll work it out.
This is the place. Let me go in and see what kind of a state he's in.
Sure. I'll wait here. Good luck. Scream if you need any help.
Very funny.
You can't stand there.
What, in the street?
Yes, in the street.
Is it your street?
Just get out of here.
Why?
I said, just get out of here.
Listen, partner. I'm waiting on a lady. She's a fine lady. She's just gone inside. If I wasn't waiting on this lady, you'd be dead already. But if you continue to irritate me, I'll kill you. I make my apologies to the lady. It's your call.
Oh, I didn't mean nothing.
Never been so demeaned in my life.
Apology accepted. Oh, wait, daughter. Right there.
I have half a mind to kill you myself.
Daddy.
No.
Oh, Daddy, please, come home. You're tired, Daddy. Tired and
I have no
unwell.
Such thing. You get away from me. You head home. I insist upon it. Leave me be. Damn nuisance.
Excuse me, partner. Still as charming as ever, I see.
Oh, Arthur, he's up to no good. We better follow him.
Okay.
This way. He went around the corner.
See why he has such a high opinion of himself. We'll just follow the smell.
Arthur, come on. He just went between those crates. Don't lose sight of him. Come here, quick.
Mind where you go. Mind where you go. Sorry?
Do you think he saw us?
I don't think so.
What did you say to me?
I didn't say a thing insulting.
I'll wipe that goddamn smirk clean off your face.
Ain't you a little old for brawling, mister?
Damn you!
He's heading across the road.
You know, this is kind of fun.
Shh, he'll hear you. You could have cleaned yourself up a bit.
I didn't realize I was here to impress anyone.
He just went left down that alleyway. What's he doing?
Let's go find out.
Hey, stop a second. You're too close. Come on, let's stay on him. What's he doing? What do you think he's doing?
Well, he's either waiting for a woman of dubious morals, or he's trying to sell something.
So, Ashton, you got the money?
Seems he's selling something.
Have you got the brooch, Mr. Gillis?
Yes. Here.
Here's the money. That is beautiful.
It's a family heirloom.
That was mother's brooch.
Not any longer, Mr. Gillis. Enjoy the money. And should you need any more, I can offer you a loan at a very reasonable rate of interest.
No, thank you. I've heard what happens to folks who take loans from you.
It's not even his to sell.
It's just a brooch. At least he didn't get himself killed.
You don't understand. Mother left it to me. You sold my mother's brooch? How could you?
You!
That's theft!
Oh, speaking of thieves, I see you found your outlaw again.
Hello, sir. Have you been well?
Daddy, how could you?
Mary, wait here. I'll go get the brooch.
Don't hurt anyone, Arthur.
He'll probably kill someone.
Hey, you, Ashton, hold her right there. Stop that coach! Get back here! You hearing me? Stop the damn coach! God damn it! You stop right now!
Leave me alone. It's just a brooch.
I want that brooch. It wasn't Gillis's to sell.
I bought it fair and square.
How much do you want for it?
I guess I could give it to you for $100.
Thank you.
Where's your father?
I don't know.
You want me to go find him again?
Not really.
Well, let's take a walk. I'll take you to the trolley.
Thank you.
Got you your brooch back.
I won't ask.
Probably best not.
Hey. What are you doing now? Right this moment?
Why'd you ask?
Well, I was wondering if you wanted to do something. Head to the theater, perhaps.
Oh, Mary, I don't think that's a very good idea.
Sure. I understand. You're still walking me to the trolley, though.
Of course.
My life wasn't supposed to... Oh. Is it too late for us, Arthur?
I can't lie to you. I'm a wanted man, Mary. If anyone close to me, well, they're wanted too, and I can't have you wrapped up in there. But it's coming to an end. This time it really is.
Run away with me, Arthur. Run away right now and don't look back.
I want to. More than anything, I want to. But I've got some people I need to take care of. Once they're free, then I'm free. Then I can disappear.
But Arthur...
If we're gonna run away anywhere, we'd need money. And soon, I'll have some.
I know you won't run away. But it's a pretty dream.
Very pretty. But I will, once I get some money. I had some. But then some fool got it trapped into a town and I can't go back to. That's another story.
I'll write you.
Yeah.
What do you want?
Excuse me? Just what I need.
Please, after you.
What do you want?
Hey, come on, what are you doing this for? Good. Let's not let this get out of hand.
Where's my horse look at now? Damn heat rash is killing me.
Hey, Lowman! Come quick!
Get back here! You stop right now! Hey, stop!
Stop! Oficial, venga, me lleva!
This is a robbery.
Just hubo, no?
Think it's best if you...
Stop, motherfucker!
Thank you. Welcome to Horner & Co. Got some local cheddar, if you're interested. Mighty fine.
Now, let's have a look.
Okay, then. Look as long as you want. Did you see those fireworks from the mayor's party? Can't imagine we'll ever get an invitation to that.
Dear boy.
Yes, here I am.
Well, we're going to need to get you smartened up a bit.
Why?
Well, you can't play at the tables on a Lanahassee riverboat looking like this.
You can't?
Not if you want to fit in so well that no one will realize you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
Are we still doing that?
Of course. We're going to fix you up so fine no one will notice a thing.
Hello. Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes, my friend here is in need of a new suit. We are playing on the riverboat this evening.
Make this gentleman look like the Duke he really is.
A very good choice, sir.
His grandfather had to emigrate. A bitter and jealous people.
Come on, let's get you to the barber.
Sure.
Good luck tonight, gentlemen.
Herr Strauss has scoped the whole thing out. It's quite ingenious, actually.
What is?
The action he has planned. Indeed, it's not much of an action at all. You play cards and win. And you're going to bet very big and flamboyantly while you win. And everyone's going to think you're some new money from the oil fields come to lay it on thick and drunk. All the while, Herr Strauss will be signaling you in your line of sight. When you bust the place, they'll take you upstairs to pay you off. And that is when Javier comes in, and you take whatever you want.
You don't think they might see an armed Mexican coming into the safe with me?
Sure, they might, but perhaps not. You will see.
The suspense is killing me.
Oh, don't be so jaded. We both know this is just the kind of innocent fun you thrive on.
Well, after the past couple of months, armed robbery don't seem such an innocent pastime.
No, but we, you, all of us, will be done here soon.
I hope so.
Come on!
My good man, could you smarten up my dear hick friend here? This unlikely fellow has made himself a fortune in the oil fields and learned himself not a lick of manners or gentlemanly deportment.
Well, very good, sir.
No, it's not good. Not good at all. Not if they're going to let him play big at the tables tonight.
There, very smart.
Come on, let's get to the docks.
I've arranged some transportation for us.
What a beautiful sky today.
Weather's always fine this time of year.
Hope you have a successful evening, gentlemen.
George, to the Grand Corrigan, please.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you. From Toad to Prince.
Yeah, this is a bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't whinny up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to burn. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. This ain't Hamlet. So, who's a mark?
Is he all right, by the way, the driver?
Oh, yes. Don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery, of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't. But the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right cards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
And what money am I playing with?
Don't worry. That has all been arranged. Your chips will be waiting for you. Ah, there she is. Come on.
Okay.
Arthur, leave any weaponry here. They'll search us when we get on. George, we'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir.
Now remember what I said, Arthur. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Yes, yes. Believe me, I heard every word.
Watch Strauss, listen to the dealer, and this should be a very lucky night.
There they are. Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you. Arthur, you remember this pair of boys we met in New York? Come on, Jim. Champagne is on dear old Arthur. He's rich as can be and feeling luckier than a turkey that survived Thanksgiving.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, dear boy. Come on, come on, let's head aboard. Drinks on Arthur. Champagne.
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time. But don't lose too much money, or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Now, where can I get a cocktail?
Feel free to join a game, sir.
Take a seat, sir.
Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Evening. Desmond Blythe.
Evening.
Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen, let's play.
I hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all fared?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have.
Hello, my
ladies.
Damn it!
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So, what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny. I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting into hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife. Interesting. They're cowgirls.
Shit! Shit!
I guess my luck held. Is that you done?
Done?
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
Well, I heard there was some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay, I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation heads up in New Hanover.
I am 100% all in, Mr. Callahan.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Parakeets.
Very good, but not good enough.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you!
No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen.
Please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure. Perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Come with me, sir. You're having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Next, we'll be hiring Negroes.
Yeah, I know.
I think you're going to like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made, but you can't have everything.
Indeed.
Well, here we are. Just give me one second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur.
I guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Idiot, huh?
Just give me one second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur.
Guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Idiot, huh?
Shit, let's hope no one heard that. Quick, clear the safe, let's get out of here. Can't believe that asshole had another gun.
The view in here is looking pretty good.
How much is there?
Must be a few thousand, plus the watch.
Nice. Now let's get out of here, come on. Let's go meet the others.
Sure.
I reckon we've only got a few minutes to get out of here.
If we're lucky.
Was that a gunshot?
It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Oh, garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. I'd give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away till we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
At the time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
That's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
No, sir. My friend is not a no-good cheat, and I beg you to take back the insinuation.
There he is.
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is. Shoot that man. Come on, Arthur. We gotta get out of here. This is... Thank you. What's our next move here?
Silly me, I clean forgot to bring my gondola.
Oh, boy, what about the alligators?
Probably just touched my leg. Well, never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch. Apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss. A Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here.
Hello.